Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, folks, we are back. It's the Alex Jones Show. I am Jason Burmes sitting in. Alex on the ground in Hardin, Montana, where they've recently launched a privatized foreign mercenary service at a local prison there. And again, the guy they put at the head of it, multiple felon, 17-plus aliases, over $1 million in lost civil suits. And he's calling himself Michael Hilton. But he has many, many aliases, and we are trying to find out who are his boss. Becky Shea, who's doing PR for them, refusing to discuss who the parent company is. But with your vigilant efforts, our listeners out there, I'm sure we will get the truth soon enough. Joining me now is really a legend, somebody I've been following for years and years and years, somebody I followed even before Alex Jones. I came across him talking about his initial publication, The War Conspiracy. I believe that was back in 1972. He's an author, he's a poet, and in my mind, he's a genius. Peter Dale Scott, how are you today, sir?
I'm very happy to be here. See you in your fine new studio.
Well, thank you very much. Why don't you just give people that don't know who you are, who are not familiar with you, you know, what your background is, what your work has been. I mean, you've done so much. You've done work on, you know, RFK, JFK, MLK assassinations, extensive work on the continuity of government programs, extensive work into deep politics and 9/11, just a huge body of work.
Yes, well, actually, all this time until I retired, I was a professor of English. So the question is, why would I get into these other fields? The answer is that before that, I'm a Canadian, and I was a diplomat for the Canadian government, and I had just enough exposure to Indochina in the 1950s to be a very early advocate that America should not make the mistake of the French and go into Vietnam. And then in researching what was wrong, the reasons why we shouldn't go into Vietnam, I became aware of Kennedy's decision to pull troops out, which was made in October of 63 and then reversed the weekend that he was killed by incoming President Johnson. And so that got me inevitably interested in the Kennedy assassination. And from all of that, I've just, you know, for those of you who are old enough to remember the 60s, it was a terrible decade because Bobby Kennedy was killed, Martin Luther King was killed. There were some other minor assassinations, too. And at the time, used to talk about that my specialty was researching parapolitics. And now I usually use the term deep politics, which seems to have taken a term which will outlast me. I think people will continue to talk about it. And I have a book by that title. So that is, and I've continued to study it because I have my conviction that if you study all of these suppressed events, you find certain elements in common. By knowing more about the Kennedy assassination, it prepares you in a way to be able to study 9/11. And I know that's an odd idea, but I have a book that's the reissue of The War Conspiracy lays out the case for saying that those two events have something in common.
Is that back in publication?
Because yeah, there's a new edition. It's not the old book. This one actually talks about 9/11 and so on.
It came out
last year.
Wow.
And if you Google for me, you'll get my website, and then from there you'll see how to get the revised War Conspiracy.
Wow, just a great interview coming up for you folks that are not familiar with Peter Dale Scott. Let me tell you, that was 1972. To put out a revised edition 36 plus years later is just excellent in my mind. I can't wait to check it out. We're going to come back. We're going to talk about the Obama administration. We're going to talk about the wars in the Middle East. This is the Alex Jones Show. He'll be coming up at the bottom of the hour. PrisonPlanet.tv, InfoWars.com.